In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Centaurus region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. The Barge Spiral Galaxy, Messier 83. The Peculiar Galaxy, NGC 5128. And the largest globular cluster, Omega Centauri. All right, let's go star hopping. Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 30 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm very simply pleased to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Well, we're back to locating some great deep sky objects, and this week I have a trio of very southern objects for you. For those of you located at about 30 degrees north latitude or below, these three targets are located in the deep southern sky. At this springy time of year, of course we're talking about the rich constellation of Centaurus, the Centaur. Spring is the best time to view Centaurus and to take advantage of its highest culmination in our skies. I think I've mentioned it before on Star Hopping that for many years I attended the Winter Star Party in the Florida Keys. The campsite where they have the WSP is between Marathon and Key West, and it lies at only 24 degrees north latitude. Having full ocean at the southern exposure, it's possible to see some extreme southerly celestial sights, such as Crux, the Southern Cross, and the great nebula Eta Carina, which only gets about 5 degrees up. But I've seen it from the Winter Star Party site when we are lucky enough to have a clear sky right down to the ocean. Positioned quite a bit above these low targets is the main body of the constellation of Centaurus, who's depicted as a centaur, half man, half horse. Centaurus's left front leg dips well below the horizon, even in the Florida Keys, and it contains our closest neighboring star, Rigel Centaurus, also known as Alpha Centauri. This is the third brightest star in the sky, after Sirius and Canopus. The Rigel Centaurus system lies only 4.3 light years away from Earth, essentially right down the block from us. If our own sun were viewed from the Alpha Centauri system, it would appear as a bright star of magnitude 0.46 in the constellation of Cassiopeia, very similar to the bright star Capella that lies close by in Auriga. But well above Rigel Centaurus, Crux and Eta Carina are a pair of gorgeous galaxies and a massive globular cluster. Let's check out the first one right after this.
Star hopping target number one.
Messier 83, also called the Southern Pinwheel Galaxy, is an amazing face-on barred spiral that we've discussed before in episode 15 of Star Hopping, but we've never gone through the effort of actually locating it. M83 is very bright as galaxies go, glowing at magnitude 7.6. It's also very large, spanning 11 minutes of arc across. To get your bearings and to move your attention to this part of the sky, we'll be using the first magnitude star Spica in Virgo as our starting point. At 11:30 local time, Spica is about 48 degrees above the southeastern horizon. About 25 degrees straight down, you'll find the fairly bright second magnitude star, Menkent, which is Theta Centauri. Now we're in the ballpark, and there's lots of pretty bright stars in this area. Ready to star hop to M83? Let's go. So move about 3 degrees to the upper right to fourth magnitude, 2 Centauri. Now move about 2 degrees upward to fourth magnitude, I Centauri. Now this one's a little tough. Move about 3 degrees up across the border into the constellation of Hydra to a sixth magnitude star. Now slide just a quarter degree to the lower right, and you'll see the oval glow of M83 appear in your eyepiece. So what's our normal practice with the face-on spiral? Use averted vision to see if you can determine which way the spiral arms are rotating. Also, if you have a larger telescope, see if you can recognize the shape of the central bar. M83 lies 15 million light years away, and its true diameter is over 100,000 light years. Ready for an unusual but very bright galaxy? Come check it out with us right after this.
star hopping target number 2.
NGC 5128 is a peculiar lenticular galaxy right in the middle of Centaurus. It's even brighter than our last target, shining at magnitude 7.0. The galaxy is the result of a merger between two smaller galaxies, so we see two galactic disks with a frenzy of star formation between them. Because of its appearance and shape, it's been given the proper name, the Hamburger Galaxy. Also because of the cataclysms going on in the center of it, it's very bright in radio waves, and it's been cataloged as Centaurus A. It's definitely one of my favorite galaxies to find an image. There's a great little asterism that I use in Centaurus to find this target and the next one. It's a little triangle just to the lower right of Menkent. See if you can see this triangle with your naked eye and then confirm it with your binoculars. So let's get started in our search for NGC 5128 and center your scope on the bright star Menkent. Now move down to the lower right about 6 degrees to find that little triangle I mentioned. These are Pi, Nu, and Mu Centauri, all about third magnitude. Mu and Nu are the pair on the right. Move to the bottom star, which is Mu. Now move about 3 degrees to the right and very slightly up, and you'll see the bright Hamburger Galaxy coming into view. At magnitude 7, this galaxy is the fifth brightest star in the sky, making it ideal for observation, although it's really only visible from the southern hemisphere and low northern latitudes. Centaurus A has been spotted with the naked eye by expert observers under very good dark sky conditions. The bright central bulge and dark dust lane are visible in finer scopes and large binoculars. An additional structure can be seen in larger telescopes. So you ready for our last target? We're definitely leaving the best for last. It's the largest and brightest globular cluster in the entire sky. Check it out right after this.
Star hopping target number 3.
The massive globular cluster Omega Centauri is one of the most amazing things you'll ever see in a telescope. Omega is easily visible to the naked eye, super impressive in binoculars, and is simply stunning when viewed through a telescope of any size. With a visual magnitude of 3.7 and a diameter of about 36 minutes of arc, it appears about as large as the full moon, actually a little larger. It fills a low-power eyepiece, and with higher magnifications, you can see individual stars at the core. I can't say enough about this globular. Words really cannot describe the amazing view you'll see. You'll just have to see it for yourself. And see it you will. Here we go on our star hop to Omega Centauri. From our little triangle, start again on the lower of the close pair of stars, Mu Centauri. Move straight down about 5 degrees to second magnitude, Alnir. Now move about 5 degrees to the right and hold on to your hat. You'll see over 1 million stars enter your eyepiece, the grand globular cluster, Omega Centauri. I expect you'll spend the next hour looking at this beast if it's the first time you've seen it. Throw in a high-power eyepiece and scan from one side to the other. The center is amazingly dense, and you'll be amazed at how far this dense region extends before you start to see black space between the stars. Omega Centauri has been known since antiquity. The Greek astronomer Ptolemy listed it in the star catalog that he compiled in the mid-2nd century. And when Johannes Bayer assigned Greek letters to the brighter stars, he also mistook this amazing cluster for a star, and he designated it Omega Centauri. I guess no one wanted to take this designation away from the king of all globulars, so this name is stuck right into the present. Wow, so these were three really great objects. It's rare you get galaxies that shine brighter than 8th magnitude, and we saw two of them, starting with Messier 83, just slightly across the border into Hydra the Water Snake. Then we moved into the center of Centaurus to find that galaxy that made you want to eat dinner again, NGC 5128, the Hamburger Galaxy, also known as Centaurus A. Then we moved a bit downward, deeper into Centaurus, to knock your socks off with the amazing Omega Centauri. Well, I know these were three very southern objects, and I apologize for teasing all of our northern viewers of star hopping. Well, all I can say is, if you ever visit Florida in the spring, look me up, and I'll show you Omega Centauri through the KPO 18-inch reflector, and that's one amazing sight. So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at kpobservatory.org/sh030. Wow, that's pretty great. 30 episodes. Anyway, where you can comment and leave any questions that you might have. So in this week's KPO newsletter, I spilled the beans to all the KPO insiders about our new astronomy video series coming up this summer. My family and I will be heading to Northern Europe and the UK starting July for a couple months. During that time, I've set up many visits and interviews at some of the great observatories and astronomical landmarks through the region. I'll be creating a series of 10 episodes of what will be called KPO's European Astronomy Tour. There are at least three great interviews with professional astronomers planned, and I'm working on the fourth. One of these interviews will be really amazing. This new program will replace the star hopping series when I'm gone, and then we'll resume star hopping after I return in September. I'm super excited about it, and I hope you enjoy this new high-level astronomy content from KPO. If you'd like to get some inside information about the new series and also get a lot of other star hopping content for free, you can sign up on our newsletter at kpobservatory.org/newsletter. Well, thank you very much for joining me here, and I'll see you next week with more star hopping tips and tricks.
I'm Cassie, and I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these video astronomy tutorials every week on Thursday, and in their podcast format on Fridays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them on the internet. The reason we create these videos and podcasts is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any requests for potential targets in the night sky that you would like to see us discuss, just let us know down in the comments section below or on our website blog. Don't miss our free field notes for this episode, basically the script of the show, with all the images and star charts we use for our star hopping activities. You can get them for free at kpobservatory.org/fieldnotes. If this is the first time you're checking out star hopping, and if you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel by clicking the big yellow button, click the thumbs up on the video, and please share this tutorial out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comment below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astronomical digital images, and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places in cyberspace, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value, and if you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a small amount per video, you can support our efforts, and help us make even more great astronomy tutorials, just like this one. So bye for now, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.